This series is for anybody who wants to dive into Drupal 8, but is unfamiliar with some of the concepts that it introduces, like object-oriented programming, Symfony integration, autoloading, plugins, and unit testing, among others. Even if you come to the table having never worked with Drupal before, you should be able to follow along, but I may make references to the way that Drupal 7 works in contrast to Drupal 8, for example, or might gloss over certain Drupal-specific terms like hooks and entities. I also assume that you have some basic PHP programming knowledge. If you're just starting out with development, I'd suggest that you watch the PHP Programming Basics video collection first, and then come back to this series. A good part of what we'll cover involves working with PHP in an object-oriented way, and it's tough to really appreciate those concepts without first having run into the limitations of the way that you program when all you're trying to do is just build something that works. The main goal of this series is to familiarize you with specific concepts and techniques so that you'll know how to find your way around Drupal 8, but also in such a way that you'll be able to use many of your new skills outside of Drupal as well. For example, when we look at object-oriented programming, it will be easier to identify key concepts in plain PHP and then introduce how those concepts are implemented in Drupal. When we dive into the Symfony framework, we'll look at the various components outside of Drupal to begin with, and then we'll address how they're used in the context of Drupal. The goal, again, is to illustrate ways that these tools can be used both inside and outside of Drupal, which will strengthen your position as a developer in your own projects and also when you're looking for paid work. So some of the big areas that we'll be covering in this series include, first, building a simple module. We'll begin by looking at where the scaffolding of a module has changed from Drupal 7 and where it's stayed the same. And this will launch us into exploring a lot of the concepts that we need to know to understand what's really going on with the code. We'll dive into object-oriented programming concepts and techniques. So we'll start from where we left off in the PHP Programming Basics collection and discuss what the big conceptual differences are, and of course, look at numerous practical examples to illustrate the different ideas. We'll look at namespacing. Now, the basics of namespacing are pretty simple, but we'll go a bit deeper and look at namespacing practices, and specifically what you need to know to take advantage of namespacing in Drupal. We'll discuss autoloading. If you don't know what autoloading is, it will seem like a lot of Drupal 8 code is just magical. Here, we dispel the magic and explain what's going on with autoloading and why. We'll dive into Symfony integration. Drupal takes advantage of numerous components from the Symfony framework, and so we'll look at how Symfony works both on its own and then explore the various components used by Drupal. We'll talk about controllers. One of the ideas that Drupal takes from Symfony is the idea of a controller, or rather a class that interfaces between data and the way you want to display the data. And if you don't know what that means, don't worry, we're going to ease into it. We'll look at Composer. So Drupal takes advantage of a PHP application called Composer. It's a powerful tool for integrating third-party libraries in your codebase. We'll look at how to use Composer for any project, which is a lot of fun, and where Drupal leverages it in particular. We'll dive into what to do with custom code in Drupal 8. So many of the techniques that you'll learn throughout this series will be useful when it comes to evaluating how you write your own custom code that doesn't necessarily fit into any of the typical Drupal conventions. So we'll explore some ideas around useful ways to apply these techniques. We'll talk about migrating modules from Drupal 7 to Drupal 8. So migrating modules in the past between major versions of Drupal has been tricky, and it's going to remain tricky from 7 to 8, but we'll talk through some of the techniques that will help your migration process go a bit more smoothly. We'll look at unit and functional testing. A big benefit of object-oriented programming is that it becomes much easier to test your code, and solid testing means that you'll find problems much faster and have an easier time troubleshooting issues. So we'll discuss the different types of testing and how to write tests for your Drupal modules. And finally, we'll discuss plugins. So there's a new concept in Drupal 8 called a plugin. We'll talk about what that is and how they exist, as well as look at some examples of how they work. If any of this or all of it sounds overwhelming right now, just take a deep breath and relax. The names and descriptions of all of these subjects might appear daunting, but when we start working through the examples, you're going to catch on really quick. and any sense of foreboding that you have now will be replaced with excitement, because this stuff is a lot of fun, and you'll start to see applications in your own work really fast, both inside and outside of Drupal. All right, let's get started.